Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Ray and B. Dillard Field here at Ashmore Park for the opening conference tilt between the Emmanuel College Lions, 5-5 on the season. They get ready to take on the 8-4 North Greenville University Crusaders. Now, the Crusaders look to keep this home turf undefeated as they now will get ready to begin their first home conference series. Ray Sutherland, Alan Ellis today with you as we look forward to today's first pitch against the Emmanuel College Lions. And on the mound, we'll take a look at the starting pitchers. Bryson Cornett, number 21, will take to the hill for the Lions. First up for North Greenville, we'll see number 99, Frankie Fernandez. But before we take a dive further in depth into today's game, Alan, we missed, I missed a very important note from a yesterday's game, and that is, do you have any idea who the winning pitcher was declared from the game two of the Northwood series yesterday?
Was it Kip?
It was Kip Rawlings.
Throws one pitch, ends up with the win.
Yes, it was. Kip Rawlings, who came in relief of Ethan Gardner, who started game two against Northwood. Then Daniel Kite went an inning and two thirds. Kip Rawlings came in. Officially listed as pitching a third of an inning, one at bat, got a ground out, one pitch thrown, and is declared the winning pitcher.
Well, that's absolutely correct. He's the last pitcher to throw before the offense took the lead. So, yeah, we did fail to mention that yesterday, but impressive nonetheless. A day later.
And we're not sure if that's some that's got to be some that, sort of record somewhere, but
that has to be a record. You can't do any better than that.
One pitch thrown, Kip Rawlings, your winning pitcher from Game Two of the Northwood series yesterday. And now taking a look at today's game, starting lineup for the Emmanuel College Lions, as they have already played one conference series. Unfortunately, they drew the number two team in the conference, Belmont Abbey, and got swept in that series, so 0-3 for Emmanuel coming into today in conference play. Their starting lineup, the center fielder, number 25, Dustin McNichol, will lead things off. Second baseman, number 5, Brock Balcom, batting second. Catcher, number 30, Phillip Swindell, batting third. Left fielder, number 24, Hannon Price, the DH today. Number 35, Daniel Gooden. Number 22, right fielder, Jacob Teston. Number 9, the third baseman, Jake Nichols. And number 12, first baseman, Jacob Saulnier. And rounding out the batting order, shortstop number 23, Ty Tipton for Emmanuel. He'll face off against number 99. That is Frankie Fernandez for NGU. And just about ready for first pitch. First conference game here on the new turf. Got it broken in with a couple of games against a non-conference opponent out of Michigan, Northwood, and Fernandez fires strike one into McNichol.
And North Greenville got behind early both games against Northwood the last 2 days, but managed to rally back to take victories there. Look for them to try and take an early lead today.
Ball 1-2 McNichol. Emmanuel, their last game they played, 10-6 loss to Anderson University. And off the end of the bat, roller to second, fielded, high throw, but in time to plunk it at first, will put McNichol away for the first out. And now here's a look at the way North Greenville line up defensively for in the field of play. Frankie Fernandez on the mound, pitching to John Jones, who's catching. In the infield from first to third, Andrew Plunkett, Jared Williams at second, Utah Jones at short, Ryan Brown at third. And the outfield coming up after ball one here now to the second baseman, Brock Balcom. In the outfield for North Greenville from right to left, you've got Connor Grant, Jack Morris, and Jeffrey Chandler. And ball two. Balcom batting 314 on the season for Emmanuel. And Fernandez fires a strike in there to him. One out here early. And another off the end of the batter. Slow roller stopped by the second baseman. Long throw will not get to first in time. What a job by Jared Williams just to get to that one. But Emmanuel will put a man on here with one out.
And just like you said, just a great stop right there at second base. Probably would have ended up being a single regardless, but nice to stop it in front. Try and keep it in the infield on a grounder.
And now big-time player to keep your eye on today for Emmanuel, Phillip Swindell, catching for the Lions. Swindell batting 400 through the 10 games for Emmanuel. And takes ball one high and inside. Big lead at first from Baucom. Now Frankie Fernandez on the hill for North Greenville, looking for a good outing today, posting up a 6.75 ERA. Now fires a strike. Rest of Fernandez numbers, no wins, no losses. Getting a second start today. Only has pitched 8 innings, giving up 10 hits. And strike one called on the low inside corner. Moves the count to 1-2.
Swindell just watched that one go by. Low, looked low and inside, but caught the corner on the way by. So instead of a 2-1 count, he's sitting at a 1-2.
Fernandez has struck out 8 on the season, only walked 1. Trying to settle some of those numbers in. And doesn't get the call on that one. We'll move it to 2-2. Runner on first for Emmanuel. And ball three missing up high. Full count to the catcher, Swindell. As yesterday and the day before, Northwood was able to get on the board both times in the opening frame, and North Greenville can get out of the opening inning without letting up any runs. Be a good day. And trying on the pickoff, no, very close over at first.
Just slid a hand back towards the bag, just got in there in time.
And Baucom is being very risky here early. He's got to takes 3 steps there. Had a big lead on that pickoff attempt. So he keeps this one a little bit shorter. Count still 3-2. Fernandez will throw over to first again and try and keep Baucom pinned back. Baucom, no stolen bases on the season for the Lions. As a team, they only have 9 through 10 games. Runner goes this time, and it's fouled away. He was going on that one.
Had a good jump towards second. Easily could have made it in time.
Well, has to take the long walk back to first. Still a full count. And Baucom will once again take his lead. Only 2 steps this time. Throw to the plate. And another foul off as Baucom was running on that one. Well, thought it was foul. And it is. John Jones popped up and went for the tag, but do believe the umpire went ahead and ruled that one foul. So, yes, Baucom, who was standing at second, thought that one was a fair ball, will now have to go all the way back.
Just offensively and defensively, both teams in the confusion trying to do what is most advantageous towards their side and making the umpire make the final call.
Now let's try again. They'll throw back to first. Well, good battle going on between Balcom and Fernandez. Balcom's tried twice to steal second already. Both times his own teammate has fouled off the pitch. And ball four high and inside will walk Fernandez. So Balcom will finally reach his desired target at second base. And that'll put two on for Emmanuel with one out. Move it down to the left fielder today for the Lions, Hannon Price. Also, I have to correct myself here early because I'll know I'll hear about it later. Listed, I gave North Greenville an extra loss. They're 8-3, not 8-4. Two on for the Lions, one out. And first pitch swing to Utah Jones at short. Chance for two. Second, first, got him. North Greenville turns two, and Fernandez gets out of the inning. What a player Utah Jones has been for North Greenville through the opening part of the season. So the Lions, no runs on one hit, no errors, and two left on base for Emmanuel. So North Greenville doesn't allow a run through the top half of the inning. Head coach Landon Powell will certainly take that one. And we'll send it to the bottom of the first. And leading off the game for North Greenville, I believe this is the same starting three that started game two against Northwood yesterday. It'll be Ryan Brown at third baseman. He'll bat first. Utah Jones, shortstop, batting second. And catcher John Jones batting third for North Greenville. And take a look at the starting pitcher for Emmanuel. That is number 21, Bryson Cornett, taking to the hill. 6.39 ERA for Cornett. One win, one loss. Gets his fourth start here today. Through 12 and two-thirds, he's given up 19 hits, 10 runs, 9 of those earned. Walked 6 and struck out 10. And 58 batters he's faced on the season. Opponents batting 328 against Cornett. And here's how the Lions will line up in the field. Mentioned Cornett on the hill. Phillip Swindell catching in the infield. It's Jacob Saulnier at first. Balcom at second. Ty Tipton at short. Jake Nichols at third. And in the outfield from right to left will be Jacob Teston, Dustin McNichol, and Hannon Price, the layout defensively for the Emmanuel College Lions. So leading off, Ryan Brown for North Greenville. Had a rough game two against Northwood. Yesterday went 0-4. With a strikeout, as only four Crusaders posted up a hit. The two Joneses had two apiece, so Brown looking to get some production out of him today. Ryan Brown batting .279 on the season for NGU. He'll have the honor of facing off against Cornett. And so here we go. First batter's through for North Greenville. Cornett on the first pitch. Missing down low to Brown. And a low pitch swing popped up into shallow left. Actually might not even leave the infield. Shortstop makes the play. And Ty Tipton puts one away. So only two pitches to put Ryan Brown away. And now Utah Jones. Big series in those two games against Northwood. Went 2-for-4 yesterday, scored a run, picked up an RBI as well, and First pitch swinging here right over to first, and that's going to put Utah away on one pitch. Cornette's made quick work of two NGU batters, and already with two down, now it's down to John Jones to keep the opening frame going for North Greenville. John Jones, he went 2-for-4 yesterday with two RBIs. Leads the NGU team in batting average at 478. And takes strike one there from Cornette.
Yeah, 478, not too shabby.
Also picked up his first home run of the season in game two against Northwood. Ball one called at the knees. Now for the 1-1. Outside for ball two. And another ball off the end of the bat and foul down the third base side. Strike two against Jones.
Ball had a lot of carry to it. Got right there to the fence. Now only looking like Emmanuel is going to try and get out in just a few pitches. Now North Greenville with a runner in scoring position.
Good placement there by John Jones to keep the inning going down to Connor Grant. Grant batting 343 on the season for North Greenville. Went 0-for-3 yesterday in game two against Northwood. And swings at the first pitch, fouls it off down the third base side. Strike two called against Grant.
Grant quickly behind 0-2.
Cornette obviously not letting the lone base runner on second and John Jones phase him. Trying to get out of the inning, and Grant hacks at it. Fair play over to short. Throw to first will put NGU away for the inning. That one just off the top part of the bat. And an easy play at short for Tipton again. So North Greenville will leave a runner stranded. No runs, one hit, no errors. And one left on base for NGU.
Just about beat the throw. Had all the speed in the world. Just great. We talked about the bounce off the turf that these balls are going to get, especially on these dribblers in the infield. And that one just about popped over the whole left side.
And if you're new to North Greenville baseball, this is all artificial turf except for the pitcher's mound here at Ray and B. Dillard Field. And in that artificial turf, if you can make it out, you'll see these black streaks. Those are all rubber pellets, and that's what's giving it that little bounce or that extra bounce that is sometimes makes these fielders second guess which way that ball's going to go.
But it's... honestly, it might end up being more consistent on the bounce than your typical grass and dirt field. You'll see in a lot of fields like that, they'll spin off, they'll hit the edge of the dirt and grass, and you'll deadpan, they'll just bounce over. You just don't expect everything, but now this may be a little more consistent, but just a little bouncier than you would normally see.
So here's due up for Emmanuel in the top of the second, scoreless between these two Carolina's foes. Daniel Gooden, the DH, will lead things off for the Lions. He'll be followed by the right fielder Jacob Teston and third baseman Jake Nichols. The three due up for Emmanuel. Oh, Each team posting up a hit, but no run scored. Fernandez facing four batters back in the first. North Greenville able to turn the double play and get out of the inning and leave two stranded for the Lions. So here's Gooden as he'll dig in to face off against Fernandez. And Gooden only his third at bat for Emmanuel, picking up his first start of the season. Does have a .500 batting average. As he'll miss the home run swing for strike one.
And Greg, just something to peg about the first inning. North Greenville versus Northwood, both games, pitchers pegged for a lot of pitches in the first inning. 28 apiece in the first game, as this one's fired just outside. So 28 apiece in the first game, 20 apiece in the second, only 16 and 11 for North Greenville and Emmanuel in this first game.
Fernandez missing down low for ball two. I'm sure Coach Powell will take as few pitches as he can this game. Didn't go to the bullpen a lot. Had his two starters against Northwood go a long ways. Tucker Burgess starter game one against Northwood went 112, and then Garner, who started game two, went 109. As strike two called at the knees after Fernandez fired ball three. So a full count here to the leadoff man, Gooden.
And just Coach Powell in a really weird situation.
Strike three called. Caught him looking.
And that was a nice one right there. Whistled right in. But just to finish the thought, Coach Powell caught in a weird situation having to play five games over the course of 4 days. So normally you'd have time to rest the guys. Your starters aren't going to have to go over 100 pitches normally, but going to look to see a lot more out of this pitching staff over these next 2 days.
And Fernandez keeping right along. Strike one into the right fielder now. This is Jacob Teston, batting .300 on the season for the Lions. And the breaking ball breaking for Fernandez, just not in the zone, 1-1 count. Fernandez, the right-hander, swing and a miss, strike two. Looks like Fernandez providing a little bit more heat than Garner yesterday and Burgess the day before him. As off the end of the bat to the press box, foul will keep the count at 1-2.
And that's just to the strengths of the different pitchers. Garner has a really good slider to left-handed hitters. And just a little more heat from Fernandez today, as you just said. Going to be the strong suit here from number 99.
For the 1-2 again, missed it up high, ball two. Garner's pitch selection, slower on the speed, but more precise. And definitely his slider, the best pitch he has to offer. Now on the 2-2. I'll fill the count up, 3-2.
He didn't have a bad curveball either. Just those off-speed pitches Garner's been able to throw. But Fernandez, he's gone well. Off-speed, not so much.
Got to get one in here. And it misses. Ball four will walk Teston here with one out. That'll be the second walk already of the game. Free pass issued earlier to the catcher, Swindell. And already Fernandez with more walks in this game than he had all season. Now the third baseman, Jake Nichols. And I'll throw to first to keep Teston back. Balcom had Fernandez a little bit nervous on the mound. Tried to steal twice, both times unsuccessful as a pitch was fouled off.
But had all the speed in the world to get there. Would have made it without question.
Well hit into right center field. Connor Grant going back for it. Got it. Runner will have to retreat back to first. And that'll put two away. That'll bring up the first baseman, Jacob Saulnier, for the Lions. Saulnier batting 265. A lefty digs in the faceoff against Fernandez. One on, two out here for Emmanuel in the top of the second. And ball one missing from Fernandez. And another off the end of the bat down the third base side, foul.
Gray, these Emmanuel hitters not really struggling to make any contact, just having a lot of trouble getting it into the field of play.
A few late swings early and often coming from Emmanuel. And Fernandez pegging the high part of the zone but missing ball two. And throw back to first. No good on testing.
These Emmanuel base runners testing their luck. Just not a bad pickoff from Fernandez. Just missing the tag by just a half a second or so.
They keep doing that. Fernandez is going to catch one of them sleeping. Check swing, reached out for it. And no appeal. Actually, there was an appeal, but second base umpire says he didn't go, so ball three. 3-1 count to the first baseman, Saulnier. Runner on first, and Fernandez threatening to put another on. And strike two called at the knees as Saulnier was holding up all the way, and Fernandez will have to deal with his third full count of this inning. Full count, two outs for the Lions. See here if testing goes. He will go on the pitch as it is hit right to first. Stopped by Grant, flipped to Fernandez, and gets to the bag just in time. Good play by Fernandez as North Greenville, we saw that play yesterday. They couldn't execute it in time as that one was hit roughly the same spot. Connor Grant had to come over to cover it, and then that left first base wide open. But Crusaders able to execute the play this time around and put Emmanuel away as the Lions send four to the plate again, but no runs, no hits, no errors. One left on base for the Lions. At least one runner left on base for the second straight inning. To the bottom of the second we go. North Greenville looking to continue through their first at-bats, facing off against Bryson Cornett, who had a good opening frame for the Lions. Andrew Plunkett, Jeffrey Chandler, and a bit of a mystery for the seventh spot hitter. We'll have to wait and see more on that in a minute as this is part of Coach Powell's strategy. So Plunkett, Chandler, and then the third batter, who we'll have to wait and see, will be coming up here in the bottom of the second. Still scoreless between Emmanuel and North Greenville. We'll be right back. Andrew Plunkett will lead this inning off for North Greenville. Both teams still looking to get a run across. Plunkett yesterday against Northwood, 0-3 with a strikeout. And Plunkett on the season averaging 265 in the batting department. And Cornett fires ball one. Cornett only needed needed 11 pitches to get through the first inning.
But per Fernandez only needed 16 to get through the first, took a whole 20 to get out of the second. So heart of the lineup, not nearly as easy to deal with.
And now a catcher issue here for Emmanuel. Part of the looks like a bad glove. He's coming out here with a second glove.
And just see here, if Swindle makes some mistakes here, baseball players have their...
Hit, left field, fair ball. As Plunkett clobbers that one into left field, and he'll pick up the leadoff single.
But just to finish up on that one, just baseball players have, you know, that ideal glove, the one they want to use, and then they'll tend to have backups waiting around just in case something like that. What just happened, but sometimes using that secondary glove, not nearly as much success. So see these low and away balls right here to Swindell, see if he has any trouble gathering these in.
Jeffrey Chandler now setting up for his first at bat. Takes ball one high and inside. Chandler's got a .293 batting average on the season. Five RBIs for him as well. Does have a double and a triple as an extra base, as extra base hits. Runner on first here, that's Plunkett. And this one clobbered right to short. The Lions with a chance to turn two. Throw to first, off target. And they won't get Chandler, but they get Plunkett at first.
Had a chance to pull a double play right there, but just the fast running from Andrew Plunkett. Going to beat the throw anyway.
And the throw from the second baseman, Brock Balcom, was way to the right of Saul Neer, who had to come off the bag to grab that one to prevent Chandler from going to second. So runner still on first here for North Greenville with one out. And this is the spot in the lineup that we're waiting to see who it's going to be, and it is number 20, Sean Parsons. First pitch to Parsons, outside, ball one. And Parsons with a 250 batting average on the season, getting his fourth appearance on the season. And 1-0. Roughly same spot outside, 2-0. And again, missing outside, 3-0 to Parsons.
Cornett just trying to catch the corner on Parsons and not quite getting there. Three pitches, relatively the same spot.
Now for the 3-0. Finds the middle there for strike one. Now, pickoff back in time is Chandler, Jeffrey Chandler, awaiting at first. Still a favorable count to Parsons, 3-1. And runner goes here, throw down the first, off target, going for the tag. Chandler is safe.
Walked him anyway, so. Really a whole lot of fanfare for nothing.
Still got to appreciate the early aggressiveness from Powell and Chandler there to send him, but it is a walk for Sean Parsons to get on board. That'll put two on here with one out. And Jack Morris, a center fielder in the eighth spot today for North Greenville, with a chance for the runner in scoring position. Morris batting 212 on the season, looking to bring that up. Did pick up a hit yesterday against Northwood as he takes strike one there. Now 0-1. Make it 1-1. Cornett takes his time, now throws. Well hit into center field. It's going to hang up. On is the center fielder to make the grab. As McNichol had to come in a few steps, we'll put two away. For NGU, runners hold at their spots. And the second baseman, Jared Williams, will step in and be the last hope for North Greenville to try and keep the inning going.
And right there, Emmanuel lucky that McNichol was able to catch that one on the run and not fall over. Had a good jump on it, didn't have to dive. So he was already running towards second, and Chandler having no chance to advance to third.
First pitch swinging from Williams. Fair ball into left field. Here comes Chandler around third, and second runner will have to hold, and it's an RBI double for Jared Williams to break open the scoring.
And now North Greenville, for the first time at Ram B. Dillard Field here at Ashmore Park, taking the lead for the first time in the game and not having to come from behind.
Yeah, Williams on the first pitch, cleaned that one up to left field. And the Crusaders not done yet. Two runners now in scoring position at second and third with Parsons and Williams. And we're back to the top of the order for Ryan Brown, who is already 0-1 today with a fly out to short. And ball one to Brown. North Greenville now leading 1-0. One and one, strike at the knees.
Yeah, that one sunk right there. It looked like it was going to be a little high. So laid off at the plate was Ryan Brown, but sunk right there at the knees. No attempt at it.
One-one. Hard hit off the end of the bat. Foul down the third base side to put Brown behind. 1-2, and now an opportunity for Cornett to get out of the inning with one run let up. One, two. Hard hit. Foul of third base.
Trying to tightrope it down the sideline, but
I'm trying to do what Williams just did, but wrong side.
Jake Nichols, though, playing hard on that third base line, so going to be hard to get by him doing that anyway.
1-2. And this one will go to second. Fielded cleanly. Throw is on target. And Cornett gets out of the inning with only a run let up. North Greenville breaks open the scoring. They lead 1-0 over the Emmanuel College Lions. One run on two hits. No errors, and North Greenville leaves two on base. Heading to the top of the third, due up for the Lions will be the shortstop Tipton, and then back to the top of the order for the center fielder McNichol and second baseman Balcom. And take a look here at the series history between these two teams. One heavily, heavily dominated by North Greenville, leading it 19 games to 3. In fact, North Greenville has won the last 11, and the last loss for this Crusader team against Emmanuel all the way back in the spring of 2011. Emmanuel did win the first ever meeting back in April of 2009, and North Greenville facing off against Emmanuel last year in the three-game set. They won the last one in March of 2017 and scoring 17 runs to win it.
But you take a look at that, and North Greenville obviously leading the series by a lot, 19-3, but that three really significant for Emmanuel, winning the first meeting, as you said, in 2009, but last win was 2011, so only three wins in the first 3 years of competition between these two teams, and now a seven-year drought for the Lions versus this Crusader squad.
And so North Greenville looking to keep the streak going. 2-0 here on the home turf of Ray and B. Dillard Field. And Emmanuel 5-5 on the season, coming off a loss against Anderson, as a shortstop Ty Tipton, the last hitter to get to the plate for Emmanuel in the batting order. And Fernandez missing high and inside. No, Tipton with the avoidance maneuver. 1-0.
Just looked like Fernandez just misplaced that one, just let it slip out of his fingers. Lucky not to hit it.
Popped up in the infield. Who's going to call it? Plunkett coming over for it. And it's instead second baseman making the grab. Jared Williams recording the out.
Just two pitches to record one out here for Fernandez here in the third. So good start after North Greenville just took the lead.
Now second time through for the Lions, the center fielder McNichol due up. 0-for-1 today with a ground out to second. And Fernandez whistles strike one by him. Dustin McNichol taking strike two.
Fernandez, after that crazy pitch just about hitting an Emmanuel batter, just been throwing constant strikes since.
Oh, hard hit into right center field, and on the run for the out, Jack Morris for out number two.
And Morris, who made several good plays in that Northwood series in center field, making a good one here against Emmanuel.
That one had some speed to it. And now two outs, nobody on for second baseman Brock Balcom. This was a good battle back in the first. And he'll swing at the first pitch and drive it toward Morris again. Straightaway center this time. Not much movement from Morris. And he'll record the last two outs to put the Lions away. So good job, Fernandez, only needing one pitch to get rid of Balcom, as Balcom singled back in the first and had a good pickoff battle with Fernandez, but no such luck coming here in the top of the third. So the Lions, all three fly out, go down in order. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. Heading to the bottom of the third, North Greenville leading 1-0. We'll get to see Utah Jones, John Jones, and Connor Grant when we come back here for the bottom of the third on the North Greenville Sports Network.
Yeah, totally spaced.
Utah Jones leading things off this inning for North Greenville. 0 for 1 today, grounded out to the first baseman. Back in the first inning, so see what Jones can do. He is instrumental in helping North Greenville get the win, get two wins over Northwood, and he'll let ball one go by here from Cornett.
Yeah, and Utah Jones and John Jones both instrumental in that win yesterday.
And off the end of the bat, through the gap into right field. Good cut by Utah Jones to get aboard with the leadoff single.
And that's exactly why they were both really instrumental in winning yesterday. Just able to get hits in a game that saw very few of them. And not just that, but getting hits at vital points of the game. See what John Jones can do here with Utah on board.
John Jones already 1 for 1 today. That's important because that is his 12th straight game with at least a hit for NGU, as he'll take strike one from Cornett. And Utah Jones at least has a 3-game home hitting streak. That's his 3rd straight with at least a hit. That was Cornett trying to keep him back. Waiting on pitch number 2, outside, ball 1. John Jones facing the 1-1 and fouling one off the first base side to make it 1-2.
And probably lucky he did foul that one off with Solnier playing real tough right there on first. Easily could have picked it up, tagged first for one out and thrown to second for an unconventional double play, but two outs nonetheless.
Still trying to keep Utah Jones back at first.
And both pitchers really using that pickoff move to try and get runners out at first, but neither successful as of yet.
John Jones facing the 1-2 count. Nobody out yet for North Greenville. And Jones reaching out for it, looping it into left field, hanging up, and there will be the first out. Jones flies out to left, and with one down, it'll see if Connor Grant can move Utah over. Grant 0 for 1 today with a ground out to short.
And Grant, who played really well defensively yesterday, trying to find some offense at the plate today.
Second best batting average on the team for North Greenville. And struggling in game 2 against Northwood yesterday. Utah Jones, no stolen bases yet on the season for North Greenville, but Cornett keeping a close eye on him. Now throws to the plate, and there goes Utah halfway down the base path. Throw is off target, and one stolen base for Utah Jones.
And now Connor Grant with a runner in scoring position and a favorable count.
Now Grant's Got 11. Now with that runner in scoring position, he's got 11 RBIs on the season. That does lead the team. Calling time here.
And North Greenville in the last couple games has been really aggressive on the base pass, and seen it right there with Utah Jones stealing second on with a one-run lead, not playing from behind or anything, but just trying to keep the foot on the pedal and run Emmanuel to their back foot.
Some protests coming from the North Greenville dugout. Not sure what about. Anyway, throw to the plate. Ball one. That is smothered by the catcher, Swindell. A big lead at second. Pickoff attempt goes into center field. And they get tangled up as there's no advance coming from Jones, who collided with the leg of the second baseman, Balcom, and he's slow to get up.
Yeah, just a bit of an awkward play right there. Both one reaching for the ball, one reaching for the bag, and ended up tumbling over one another, and Coach Powell coming out to talk to Utah Jones.
That was a break for Emmanuel, too, as that one did get away into center field, and had Jones had a clear path to third, he more than likely would have taken the base.
Just a gutsy play by Cornett anyway, because a pickoff to second is not the easiest thing to do, having to spin completely 180 back around and try and throw someone out behind you is not to much success usually. And just good to see Bauckham just, you know, a little bit of pain, but walking it off.
Yeah, he seems to be okay now. Connor Grant still waiting patiently at the plate, has only seen one pitch. Still sitting at the 1-0 count, and he'll drive this one into shallow right. That's hanging up there and finally comes back to earth, and no advance from Utah Jones. Two away. Andrew Plunkett will come down to him to keep the inning going for North Greenville. Plunkett already 1-for-1 today with a single back in the second to lead that inning off. Now Plunkett, see if he can add to his four RBIs. As Cornett fires strike one by him. And pickoff attempt a second. Boy, Utah Jones just barely does get back in time again. North Greenville already leading 1-0. Crusaders 1 run on 4 hits. And ball one, first pitch there to Plunkett, missing. Or no, that's second pitch, 1-1 count. And for the 1-1, also down low, ball two. Two-one count. Plunkett hammers it foul into the NGU bullpen.
Had a lot of power, just swung a bit too early and pulled it back around.
Well, two balls, two strikes, and two outs for Cornett to try and keep the lead at one for NGU. And on the pitch, low looper into left center field. There goes Jones around third, heading for home. And he will easily score as the throw comes back in. And Plunkett will pick up the two-out RBI single.
And North Greenville have been very successful in the last few games, scoring with both runners in scoring position, but also with two outs on the board. Knocking both categories off with that one right there.
They had one two-out RBI yesterday in the second game against Northwood. And surprisingly, North Greenville only went 2-for-10 with runners in scoring position. Or no, they went one for five.
Did much better in the first game against Northwood, but across the series has been fairly good, as this one is a steal attempt.
Runner went on the first pitch and somehow avoided both the ball and the second baseman, Balcom. Plunkett stealing second.
The throw was low, bounced right there in the turf, and just bounced over both the runner and the shortstop, with the second base coming back to cover.
Meanwhile, it's Jeffrey Chandler now in the batter's box. Chandler reaching on a fielder's choice back in the second, came around to score the first run of this game. And golfing and missing at the next pitch.
That golf swing still looked better than mine ever did.
Can't really say, don't really have a response back to that because I've never golfed. A runner at second here for Chandler. And a ball missing up high. 2-1 count. Oh, no, it's a 2-2 count, so Cornett, once again, knocking on the door, trying to get out of the inning. And just missing it up high, ball three. So runner on second for Chandler. He's got a payoff pitch coming up. North Greenville already leading by two, looking for three. And pickoff, back to second. Not in time, as it is Plunkett once again escaping the tag. Everybody gets set again. And swing and a miss. Strike three will put Chandler away. And end the inning for North Greenville. Still another productive one. One run on two hits, no errors. And one left on base. That inning for North Greenville. That was the first strikeout of the game for Cornett. North Greenville leading 2-0 over Emmanuel. The Lions, for the top of the fourth, will send Swindell, Price, and Gooden to the plate. And all that and more coming up as we're through 3-2-run lead for North Greenville over Emmanuel here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
ones who I can see. So not the white ones. Nope. The black ones or the red ones. Then.
Yep.
There's one.
No, I like this one.
Back here for the top of the fourth, North Greenville and Emmanuel. Opening conference tilt for North Greenville. Emmanuel already down 0-3 in the conference Carolinas after getting swept by Belmont Abbey. That's Frankie Fernandez on the hill for NGU, firing strike one into Swindell, who walked back in the first on a full count. Two walks and a strikeout for Fernandez through three as he misfires ball one. On the 1-1. Strike two. A 1-2. High fly ball into right center field is going to be caught on the run by Connor Grant, stepping in front of a center fielder to snag the out.
Yeah, Grant and Morris, late call there by Grant to say, I got it, but ends up getting it in time, avoids a collision, and records an out.
And those are the ones you got to call for, and Grant and Morris exchanging a few words after the out. And now Price, the left fielder, sets up and takes ball one. Hannon Price grounded into a 6-4-3 double play back in the first to in that inning. And Fernandez misfiring before it even gets to the plate, 2-0. And up high for 3-0. In danger of a four-pitch walk, and that's no strike. Strike one is called.
Yeah, just tried to hit every side, missed inside, missed above, missed outside, and just caught it on the lower end of the zone there.
Now Fernandez got to keep it up. And that one missing inside, so it will be a five-pitch walk to Price. Third free pass of the game issued by Fernandez. We'll move it down to the DH for Emmanuel. Daniel Gooden, who is 0-for-1, struck out looking back in the second. And Fernandez missing down low, ball one.
Fernandez just top 50 in that last at bat, starting to lose a bit of his command here.
Last six pitches, five of them have been balls. Big lead from first, no steal attempt as ball two missing outside. And here comes the North Greenville catcher, John Jones, out to talk to Fernandez.
Yeah, just trying to calm Fernandez down a little. Just two-run lead. Don't want to start walking a bunch of guys on for Emmanuel. Still a double play opportunity here if Fernandez can pull a ground out of Gooden.
You're on a 2-0. And a liner into right field. Gets down on a hop and jumping up for it to is Connor Grant. That one almost got over his head off the first bounce, and so a walk and a single will put two on for the Lions and bring up the right fielder, Jacob Teston, who walked back in the second.
But just what a play by Grant over here in right, realizing this turf is going to have one heck of a bounce to it. Just essentially stopped and jumped straight up and made sure to pull that one down.
Strike one from Fernandez to Teston. Otherwise, that had That had at least one run scoring for Emmanuel written all over it, and possibly a triple for Gooden. Runners at first and second, one out. And Fernandez missing down low, one and one. One, one. Down low again, ball two. And there's a strike, strike two called on the outside. Emmanuel's starting to let Fernandez work himself out in the top of the fourth. And Fernandez able to pull one back, 2-2 count to Teston. And chopper over to short, chance for two here. There's one, and not fielded by Plunkett. And the ball is loose in the infield. They get the runner at second. And only one out recorded there after the throw in and out of the glove of Plunkett. We'll put two outs on the board. With the third baseman, Nichols, coming up with a chance to score one for Emmanuel.
Just a bit of a scare right there for North Greenville. Plunkett didn't get that one in his glove, but as it was just still rolling around, several of the other guys in the infield started to realize Emmanuel could still score from third.
Yeah, that's a live ball. So runners at the corners for Nichols, who's 0 for 1 today with a fly out to right. And takes ball one. So Teston reaching on the fielder's choice. Out was recorded at second. Runner also at third here for the Lions. There's strike one to Nichols. Oh boy, Fernandez starting to get up there in the pitch count too. Is that over 661? And high and inside, ball two. Two-one count, and hard hit to Jones at short, flip to second, and that will get Fernandez out of the inning.
No damage done, and all that hard work for Emmanuel just really goes for naught.
No runs, one hit, no errors, two left on base there for the Lions through the top half of the fourth inning as they strand their first run 90 feet away from home. Heading to the bottom of the fourth inning, and should still see Sean Parsons up after switching in the bottom of the first inning. That's a strategy Coach Powell pulled quite a few times last year. So expecting to see Parsons, Morris, and Jared Williams, bottom of the order, leading off the bottom of the fourth for North Greenville as the Crusaders lead it 2-0 over Emmanuel here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Sean Parsons will indeed lead off the bottom of the fourth here for North Greenville. Parsons walking back in the bottom of the second before being stranded at third. And takes ball one from Cornett.
Now we saw Fernandez, once he got past the 50 mark, start really losing command of his throws. Cornett just throwing 50 on that pitch.
And check swing, but I believe he did go, and yes he did. Strike one against Parsons. And swings over the top of it, strike two. One, two, and a chopper back to the pitcher, and flip to first. We'll sit Parsons down.
Nice play right there by Cornett. Did the same thing Connor Grant did in the outfield, realized the bounce was going to be a lot higher than usual, jumped straight off the mound for it.
So one down for North Greenville here in the bottom of the fourth. And center fielder Jack Morris due up as he is 0 for 1 today with a fly out to center. And ducks under ball one. And scoots out of the way of ball two. And calls time against Cornett. First two pitches, and Morris has looked more like a Olympic figure skater than a batter. Ducked under one, jumped out of the way of another. And no movement there, but he'll take ball three.
All right, Cornett has to realize this is a batter's count. It's 3-0. More than likely, he's not going to swing, so just fire one in there.
Exactly what he does for strike one. Three and one. He'll foul this one off, and we're at a full count. And hard hit right to second for the out.
Just line out right there to balk him. Didn't even really have to move. Came right to him.
Short-lived opportunity for Morris, second out. And Jared Williams up to bat from his nine spot. One for one today with a double. Back in the second, scored a run. So an RBI is he'll pull back the bunt attempt and take ball one.
Just in time, too. Just let that bunt hang there, even though the ball was nowhere close. Pulled it out just before the ball got there.
1-0. And right back to the pitcher, Cornett, and he'll put the inning away. North Greenville goes down in order. 1-2-3. First time today that's happened. And we're through four. North Greenville still leading at a score of 2-0 over Emmanuel. So to the top of the fifth we go. And the Lions will send Saulnier, Tipton, and back to the top of the order for McNichol to the plate. See if Frankie Fernandez can sit him back down again. So North Greenville leading by two. I'll be right back for the top of the fifth here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
$5 to go see.
I don't deserve a chance. That's insane. That's insanely cheap.
Best in the world.
Well, it's because we still have professional women's hockey players playing.
Wow!
And top of the fifth, Emmanuel leading off with the first baseman, Saulnier. That's Jacob Saulnier. And Fernandez missing high and inside. Saulnier 0 for 1 today with a ground out to first. And a flip to the pitcher. And reaching out for it and fouling it away. Now 1-1 and jammed him up inside, or strike two.
And great, this has turned into a bit of a pitcher's duel right here. Neither pitcher really having an advantage on the other one. North Greenville just plating a couple. Took a lot of work to do it.
And reaching out for it off the pitcher's mound, off of second base and into center field as that single hits about everything on its way into the outfield and the leadoff single for Saulnier.
Yeah, just ramped off the pitcher's mound, just came right down the other side, rolled up, bounced off second base, just dribbled in until Morris picked it up. But luckily for the Crusaders, only a single for Emmanuel.
And now the shortstop Tipton. The righty will set up, nobody out, runner on first. Trying to keep the Lions back yet again. And runner almost thought about going there on that ball from Fernandez. One out count. Looking for the bunt. Fernandez fires up high again. Ball two.
As Fernandez is getting tired, he's just starting to start rising. All the pitches he was throwing with heat, not throwing with as much force, and they're not getting down in the zone.
And the bunt popped up and fouled over the backstop. Strike. Sigh of relief there from Fernandez as he finally gets strike one. And Rares back on this one. Chopper to Utah at short, and no chance for two. They do get the lead runner as Tipton will reach.
This is a smart play right there for Williams. Was about to rare and throw it over to Plunkett, but realized he wasn't going to make it in time. So rather than risk overthrowing first base, just hold on to it.
Well, still one out. As Utah Jones on the play to second to retire Saulnier. And we're back to the top of the order for Dustin McNichol, who is 0 for 2 today with a ground out to second and a fly out to center. Swing and a miss, strike one. 0-1. Make it 0-2. As the activity has begun in the North Greenville bullpen. Fernandez with an 0-2 count. And the chopper over to Utah at short. Flip to second. Chance for two. And won't be able to again get the runner at first. But again, the lead runner once more retired.
And a valiant effort that time. Just not sitting on it and waiting. But still getting the lead runner in the process. And now Emmanuel still sitting in the same situation they've been this entire time. One runner on. Just picking up out after out for the Crusaders.
Brock Baucom, a lefty, second baseman today for the Lions, 1-for-2, singled back in the first before being stranded at second. Fernandez no good on the pickoff attempt. Two down now for Fernandez and company as he'll throw to the plate and miss it low and inside. Ball one. And ball two missing outside. 2-0. Low end away, ball three. Now Fernandez got to get one in now, 3-0 count, and does so, strike one. Got to do it again. Runner goes. As it will be ball four anyway to Baucom. So McNichol at second. Baucom now at first after the walk. And the catcher, Swindell, due up. As he has also walked today. And Fernandez fires strike one by him. NGU only need one more out to get out of the inning, but Fernandez still putting him on.
Yeah, Fernandez putting him on, but if any good news coming out of that, now three different places to go to force out.
And Fernandez right back to work, firing two quick strikes by Swindell, who has yet to move a muscle. Oh, 2 count, two down, Fernandez. Fires. Strike three is called.
Just three straight pitches after walking a man to retire the final batter North Greenville needed.
And so that will strand two for Emmanuel. No runs on one hit, no errors. And those two left on base says that is, see, Emmanuel's left 3-5. That is seven left on for Emmanuel through the top of the fifth. To the bottom of the fifth we go. North Greenville went down in order last inning. Try and correct that with the top of the order due up. Brown, Utah Jones, and John Jones. As North Greenville leads at 2-0 over Emmanuel here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
Did you miss me dying in that inning?
Yeah, I heard you. I finished my comment, and I just muted my mic.
ball coach. They should have called that dude from Northwood. Yeah. This dude's like almost crow hop. Take his foot like that far above the bag and then turn around and then step on. What?
There is a discussion about runners sliding past the base.
Bottom of the fifth between North Greenville and Emmanuel. Crusaders leading off with Ryan Brown. And between innings there, if you were looking at your screen, Coach Powell came out to talk with at least one of the umpires and having a friendly discussion with them about runners sliding past the bases. Strike one fired from Cornett to Brown. So obviously Emmanuel, Coach Powell not liking what Emmanuel's doing on the base pass.
And this is something we've been wondering about this entire time on this turf, what sliding on it was going to be like. So sliding past the base, not really out of the question, but the umpires are going to have to call it if it comes to that.
Ball one issued to Brown. He's 0 for 2 today with a fly out and a ground out. And now takes ball two outside. And strike two called. I'll work it up to a 2-2 count. Here on the throw. Popped up in the infield and relatively straight up. Here comes the third base on, and he's got it.
Third baseman into what really normally should be pitcher-catcher territory. But regardless, pop out to the infield. And that'll be the first out for the Crusaders.
Another tough day for Brown. He has yet to get one out of the infield as he has flown out to short, grounded out to second, and now flown out to third. And Utah Jones, next man up here with one out. Jones 1 for 2 today with a single his last time up, back in the third. And takes strike one here. Also a stolen base to his credit today.
First of the season.
And a run scored. Oh one. Fouled off the backstop, 0-2.
Cornett looking to get out of this fifth inning a lot quicker than Fernandez was able to. Only sitting at 68 pitches, Fernandez got up to 82 after his five full innings.
Oh, two. Outside, ball one. And reached out for it off the end of the bat. Foul down the third base side. And the bullpen's starting to pick up business. North Greenville did have one warming up earlier, and a steady crowd has been building in the third base Crusader bullpen. And on the first base side for Emmanuel, they have a couple just tossing back and forth as a liner to short or second. We'll put Utah away on the ground out. Two up, two down so far for Cornett here in the bottom of the fifth. And John Jones will come up as he is 1 for 2 today. Flew out his last time up back in the third, but did manage to extend his hitting streak for North Greenville to 12 games. Has had a hit in all 12 games this season for NGU. Looking for yet another multi-hit game as he'll swing at the first one, drive it to right center field, back to the wall, and gone.
Just went the distance on that one. No doubt right field just went right to the fence and watched it go. And North Greenville One pitch in that at bat, and a 3-0 lead for the Crusaders.
To John Jones with his second home run of the season after getting number one yesterday against Northwood. And it's a 3-0 lead, and Connor Grant looking to keep the momentum going and pick up his first hit for today as Grant 0-for-2 with a ground out and a fly out. And they'll swing at the first pitch and foul it off. Oh, one count to Grant. And he'll foul the third one away for strike two. And that's another multi-hit game for John Jones. In fact, I think he's gotten at least two hits in all three home games this year. Now Cornette has Grant behind the 0-2 count, two outs, and a chance to get out of the inning with only one run let up again. And that one golfed away by Grant down the third base side. Still 0-2 count. Now, three runs on six hits now for North Greenville. Another good hitting performance.
You know, that's some production right there from the Crusader lineup. And Utah Jones and John Jones proving crucial once again today.
Grant laying off ball one there. And golf swung at it, dropped third strike, throw down to first. Will just barely beat the foot racing Grant. And so he will go down on strikes. That's out number three, not before John Jones does more damage with his bat. A solo shot over the right field fence puts North Greenville up 3-0. And we'll head to the top of the sixth. Frankie Fernandez, believe he is trotting back out there. North Greenville has had at least one warming in the bullpen. Looks like they will stay out there. So top of the sixth coming up. Emmanuel down three. Due up for the Lions will be Price, Gooden, and Teston when we come back here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Top of the six, Emmanuel North Greenville in Conference Carolina's baseball action. North Greenville leading by three. And Frankie Fernandez, strike one, issued to the left fielder for the Lions, Hannon Price. Let's see, Price 0-for-1 today with a ground out into a double play and a walk back in the fourth. And big swing and a miss for strike two.
Ripped right out that one. Level just rose right above where he was swinging.
And now Fernandez again losing a handle on that one up high for ball one. Well, this is a key inning for the North Greenville starter, Frankie Fernandez, as this one fouled off. Ethan Gardner yesterday went through six. The day before him, Tucker Burgess went seven. And right now, I believe it's number zero, Sal Lavaggio, who is warming in the bullpen for NGU. But if Fernandez can get through the six here, this will set NGU up very nicely for the remaining three, as hard hit into right field and fair ball. Extra bases here for Price. Around first, heading to second. Around second, heading to third. Here comes the throw in, and it is a triple for Price.
And just so, that throw came right in on him, and that tag just missed. But a leadoff triple here in the sixth for Emmanuel. Been blanked on the board so far. Now, serious threat.
And the DH, Daniel Gooden, the lefty, sets up against Fernandez. Nobody out, runner on third, and a big lead. That's strike one from Fernandez.
You know, if you're Emmanuel, just... what's the harm in taking a big lead right here? You're forcing Fernandez to worry about someone getting his peripherals.
Fernandez missing up high again, a common problem he's had through today, 1-1 count. Fouled away off the end of the bat, 1-2.
Here, Fernandez just eclipsed 90 on the pitch count.
Now two up and warming in a North Greenville bullpen as this hit into left field. So here comes one run in for Emmanuel as they're starting to tee off on Fernandez. That will cut the lead to two and the RBI single for Gooden. And Jacob Teston steps up, as walked and reached on a fielder's choice, and here comes the meeting to the mound.
And more than likely, this is going to be it for Frankie Fernandez.
And the call has been made to the bullpen.
But just good work all around for Frankie Fernandez this entire game through five-plus innings. Only allowed one run, still responsible for the one on first, but not too shabby at all from number 99.
It looks like Coach Powell wants the lefty. Out of the bullpen. And I didn't even have to see the number. I can already guess at who is coming to the mound because of the Frank Sinatra that just started firing up. And from Long Island, New York, it is the left-handed senior, Sal Lavaggio.
Just take a look at those numbers from Frankie Fernandez right here as Lavaggio is starting to warm up. Five innings, five hits, one run. That one earned, four walks, two strikeouts. One triple given up through 91 pitches and had a fair share of five flyouts, seven groundouts. Did well from the mound for the batters he's faced.
And so Fernandez's day is done. And so it will be up to the New Yorker to get three outs here for North Greenville in the top of the sixth. Emmanuel's got one across. Runner on first, nobody out. And Lavaggio's going to have to face the right fielder, Teston, Nichols, and Saulnier. I like that. That's a nice touch. And Lavaggio, his numbers, he's got a 3.86 ERA. No wins, no losses. This will be his fourth appearance. And through two and a third, he's given up five hits. Walked two, struck out four. Opponent's batting 455 against him. I think they're just going to let the song go. You can't interrupt Sinatra.
Yeah, just got to let it play out.
Now Lavaggio's ready to go. And Teston stepping back in. And first pitch on the way. Missing downstairs. Ball one. Pitch number two, called strike. Now 1-1. Make it 2-1. And we might be seeing the end of the day as well for the Emmanuel starter, Bryson Cornett. They've got two up on their side in the bullpen. And a hard hit fly ball into left. And called for, caught by Jeffrey Chandler, who came sprinting in for the first out.
And just had to avoid some contact right there, running in from the infield.
Well, Utah Jones covering a lot of ground also to get out there, as it'll be Jake Nichols stepping up next. He's 0 for 2 with a fly out and a ground out. And watch a strike one go by. And we'll let ball one go by down low. So correct me if I'm wrong. We shouldn't have another Kip Rawlings situation. Fernandez is in line for the win North Greenville can hold on for the
lead. Fernandez still in line for the win as of right now. So
now ripper right to third. Chance for two here. Throw to second. Got one. Got first. Yes.
Foot came off the bag, but had already made the play beforehand.
And the first base coach for Emmanuel still standing there trying to plead his case. And I think he will go unheard. So North Greenville able to turn two to get out of the inning with one run let up. One run does score for the Lions on two hits, no errors, and one left on base for Emmanuel. Head to the bottom of the second. North Greenville looking to get back on the scoring track. Andrew Plunkett, Jeffrey Chandler, and Sean Parsons do up for the Crusaders when we come back here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
Thank you.
Bottom of the sixth. North Greenville and Emmanuel. 3-1 lead for the Crusaders almost through two-thirds of this game. Emmanuel finally able to get across home plate back in the top half of the frame. And strike one issued to Andrew Plunkett as Bryson Cornett still out there for the Lions.
Yeah, only thrown 78 pitches, well short of what Fernandez had thrown. So look for him to try to get through this sixth inning, maybe even the seventh.
And a hard hit ball to right center field, tailing away, will not clear the fence, off of it instead. And here comes an extra base opportunity for Plunkett, and he will have the double.
Hit the top of the hit just on the top of the fence, missing the yellow bar signaling a home run. So that'll wind up being a double instead, and it looks like Plunkett's going to get pinch run for.
He will indeed. Plunkett, that's his third hit of the day. He is 3-for-3 with a single, well, a pair of singles and a double. And instead, let's see, number 26, Cameron Norgren will come in for him. And Jeffrey Chandler steps up to the plate. Chandler's reached on a fielder's choice, struck out swinging today. And swings at the first pitch, chopper to short, fielded, and long throw is in time. Oh, my.
And just a big argument coming from the Crusader side. But regardless, that call is going to stand.
And Ty Tifton took three steps before he threw the ball and still got the out. Runner able to advance to third, though. And Sean Parsons, see what he can do here. Here comes head coach Jeff Kilgore for Emmanuel out from the dugout. And Cornett's not done yet. Parsons 0-for-1 today with a walk. And here comes the umpire to break up the meeting, and so we're going to get right back to it. Cornett with a runner on third after a great defensive play from Tipton at short to get at least one out on the board. Now Sean Parsons poised for an RBI opportunity to try and bat in the pitch runner, Norgren, at third. First pitch swing, chopper foul of first.
But now North Greenville, in the same situation Emmanuel was. In the top of the inning, runner on third. Less than two outs, so get this one anywhere out of the infield and should put a run on the board.
0-1. Up high, ball one. Now 1-1. Outside, 2-1. Now Cornett now northward of 80 pitches. 2-1. Golfed over third, foul. Strike two. Number 31, Ethan Bailey, and 39, Zach Wells, both right-handers, are warming in the Emmanuel bullpen as ball three is rolled to Parsons for a full count. Stop. Full count, one out. And swung on foul into the Lions dugout.
Now right here for Cornette, it's really doesn't hurt you to just throw one on the corner that's going to be hard to hit, and you run a risk of walking him, but no harm, no foul, really, if it comes to that. Just try and avoid a hit here for the Lions.
3-2, off the end of the bat into center field. Hanging up, will drop, base hit for Parsons, and the RBI as Norgren comes in to score.
And that's exactly what you're trying to avoid when you're sitting at a 3-2 count with a runner on third. But too little too late, and that's going to put another run on the board for North Greenville as they push back to a 3-run lead.
And here comes a man out for Parsons. So new runner at first for North Greenville. And no movement yet out of the Lions dugout for a pitching change as Cornette looks to stay in. He'll face off against the center fielder, Jack Morris, who's 0-for-2 today with a line out right to second and a fly out to center. Yep, no change coming up just yet. So Cornette will give up his fourth run of the day and face off against Morris here with one out, runner on first.
That'll be Toby Sponseller coming in to pinch run.
Junior out of East Berlin, Pennsylvania. One-oh count to Morris, and make it 2-0.
Now Cornette about to eclipse 90 in his pitch count right here on this delivery.
A 1-0 waiting on it. And 2-0. Sponseller over there dancing around, making the catcher nervous.
It'll actually be 3-0.
The stat's a little slow. And strike there for him. Cornette, make it 3-1. And rolled to him for ball four.
Just laid off of it, too. He wanted it.
Jack Morris gets aboard with the walk. He'll move Sponseller over to second. 2-1 here with one out for North Greenville, and this might be it for Cornette.
And that looks like that is going to be it.
Now, which right-hander is Coach Kilgore going to pull out of the bullpen? And it looks like to me that's number 39.
And it is.
Which will be the junior from McDonough, Georgia, the right-hander Zach Wells, in to take over for Bryson Cornette.
And Cornette's going to exit the game 5 1/3 innings, 8 hits on 4 runs, all earned, 2 walks, 2 strikeouts, giving up 3 doubles and a homer, so 4 extra base hits, 6 flyouts and 8 groundouts to 92 pitches thrown, so... Crusaders didn't get a lot of hits off him, but when they did, they were for a lot of extra bases.
John Jones' second home run of the year came off Cornette. See, those doubles will be credited to also one to John Jones. Plunkett got a double off of him, as well as a pair of singles.
And then his stat line not finished just yet. The runners on first and second, both going to be charged to Cornette. So that's as of right now, but could end up giving up more runs.
Waiting on, well, first the warm-up pitch is from Wells, and then the second baseman, Jared Williams, will step up. Williams, one for two today. He has the other double I was looking for on the stat sheet. Grounded out back to the pitcher, his last time up back in the fourth. Zach Wells on the season for Emmanuel. 2.35 ERA, no wins, no losses. Fifth appearance here today in this game through 7 2/3, has given up 7 hits. 3 runs, 2 of them earned, walked 4, struck out 8. Faced 32 batters and opponents betting 219 against him. So Emmanuel trying to keep this one close as we transition into the late game. Hit over to third, bobbled by the third baseman. We'll get the lead runner.
But only just bobbled it right there. Trying to tag him on the way by and throw back to first. But eyes got ahead of his hands.
Out number two. Runner still at first and second. And back to the top of the order, Ryan Brown. Down to him to keep the inning going for North Greenville. And here comes another pitching change.
One pitch, one out. Pulling a Kip Rawlings, but
I don't think he's going to be
not going to be in line for the win.
And this was the other righty that was in the bullpen for Emmanuel, number 31, Ethan Bailey, a freshman from Sugar Hill, Georgia. And so we'll go look at his numbers.
Yeah, try it. While you're doing that, just try this one on for size. So runner on second, charge to the starter. Runner on first, charge to the first reliever. So three stat lines open at the moment.
Now Wells with Bailey with a 2.08 ERA, one win, no losses. He'll get his fourth appearance through 8 2/3. He's given up 10 hits, 5 runs, 2 of them earned, 6 walks, 5 strikeouts, faced 36 batters, and opponents batting 278 against him. And I think that might be it for now from the Emmanuel bullpen.
Well, considering no one else is warming up, I would hope so.
Here in the bottom of the sixth, North Greenville looking for their first conference win here at home. These two teams will be back at it tomorrow for games 2 and 3, part of our Saturday afternoon doubleheader. Game 2 at noon will run 7 innings, unless it runs to extras, then we will play that one out. And game 3 will be cut down to 7. So 12 p.m. first pitch tomorrow for game 2, somewhere around 3 o'clock. For game 3, can't make it out here to the newly christened Ray and B. Dillard Field here at Ashmore Park, home of North Greenville University baseball. We'll catch that live here on the North Greenville Sports Network. And then Tuesday, we're back across the Highway 414 for North Greenville softball, splitting a series, non-conference series with South Atlantic opponent Tusculum. North Greenville softball still looking pretty solid on the season.
Yeah, finally jumped up into the rankings after splitting a series with number 20 at the time ranked Carson Newman. North Greenville themselves jumping into the D2 rankings in the low 20s. So good to see that. And then men's volleyball next week as well on Wednesday, Greg.
Now Wednesday night, 7 p.m. from Hayes Gymnasium, taking on Erskine. And that will close us out for the month of February.
I mean, the shortest month had a lot of games, Greg.
Yes, it did. No leap year either.
28 days.
Ryan Brown digging in and takes ball one from... This is Bailey, right? Bailey.
Yeah.
These teams got to stop pulling one pitch pitchers on me.
Well, Bailey here about to... double what the last reliever did.
Brown swings at the second one. High chopper right to short. Tag at second. And, well, retire the side. So they end up catching Williams for the out. And that will bring us to the end of the sixth. North Greenville up now 4-1 with one run on two hits. No errors. Two left on base, that inning for NGU. Heading to the top of the seventh, the Lions do up with Saulnier, Tipton, and back to the top of the order for McNichol here in Conference Carolina's baseball on the North Greenville Sports Network. Top of the seventh, North Greenville leading Emmanuel 4-1. And some pitch runners coming in back in the bottom of the sixth for North Greenville. So changes have been made. Cameron Norgren now at third in place of Ryan Brown,
who just moves over to first.
In the place of Plunkett, who was pitch run for. And Sal Lavaggio stays on the mound and has his first pitch fouled away by the first baseman for the Lions, Jacob Saulnier, who is 1-for-2 today, did pick up a single back in the fifth. Behind here, 0-1.
And all that moving around just put Sponseller in the DH spot after all that.
And we might even see Coach Powell change that again.
More than likely, actually.
Off the end of the bat, foul down the third base side. And that's strike two. Vaggio looking for his first strikeout. Won't get it as ball two goes by down low. Two-two. Swung it up high, fouled away. And ball three goes by, skipping off the plate. Full count to Saulnier.
And Lavaglia only needed seven pitches to finish out the inning in the sixth. Already thrown, that's his seventh here.
Driven high to center field. Morris camping underneath it. And Jack Morris records a first out. Now shortstop, Ty Tipton, who has flown out today and reached on a fielder's choice, was also the second out in the fifth inning. He'll come up to bat here with one out. And take ball one. And we'll let ball two go by, same spot.
And some more relievers getting ready to start getting warmed up in the Crusader bullpen. As John Jones comes out, let's talk with this pitcher for a second.
Emmanuel's got two more up as well. Only one throwing, though. Well, Lavaglio behind now. We'll pull one back, make it 2-1. And fouled away. We'll even it up at 2-2. And a looper into shallow right. We'll hang up and be caught for the second out.
And just pretty easy on Williams. Just casually strolling over and waiting on the ball. Recording the second out.
Back to the top of the order for the center fielder, McNichol. Who is 0-3 today. Reached on a fielder's. I have him reaching as a fielder's choice on his last time up. He's already taken strike one. And he'll take strike two.
Listed 0-3 on the day, so yeah, reached on a fielder's choice officially in the stat book as well.
See, I can do it too.
Hey, you know how to score things.
Ooh, takes ball one high and inside. A 1-2. Ooh, doesn't get the call on the outside. Make it 2-2.
Tried to be a little fancy with that pitch, catch the outside corner, but not gonna get what he wants out of that.
And the 2-2. Got the call on the inside. Strike three.
Just what a pitch right there at the knees, just right up on the plate, right inside on top. So. Going to retire the side here in the seventh.
And North Greenville and Lavaglio doing something they haven't, for the first time, they hadn't done yet today, and that is putting Emmanuel down in order, 1-2-3, for the first time here in the top of the seventh. Time to stretch here in the seventh inning. For the bottom of the seventh coming up for North Greenville, it will be the top of the order, Ryan Brown, Utah Jones, and John Jones, who's having yet another big day for North Greenville. So 1, 2, and 3 do it for the Crusaders as they lead 4-1 when we come back here on the North Greenville Sports Network. All right, so correction, it is Utah Jones who is due up first, not Ryan Brown. Apparently, I do not know how to score. As Jones takes ball one from the second reliever coming into the game, this is Ethan Bailey on the mound. Brown was credited with reaching on a fielder's choice. Williams was out at second, and that's what ended the inning. Jones ahead in the count here, 2-0. And moves it to 3-0. Utah Jones listed as 1-for-3 today, scoring a run, stealing a base. And takes strike one. And no call there on the low side corner. Ball four to Jones. We'll walk him.
Just leadoff runner on board. See what North Greenville can do with that. And all homestand long, Utah Jones and Jaden Jones been the two that have really been the threats against opposing pitching. And now with one of them on, the other one's on right there in the box.
See how Emmanuel handles John Jones this time? A double and a home run. That was his last at bat back in the fifth. And he'll take ball one. Now 1-0. Outside, 2-0. It doesn't look like they're going to offer him anything inside.
Yeah, they're not going to give him a chance to pull one and push it out of the park again. So, I'm going to throw outside, 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 and just hope he doesn't do anything.
Well, that one gets called a strike as Utah was taking the big lead from first. A 2-1. And a chopper to second. Chance for two for Emmanuel. They get Utah at second. Turn to John at first. And they at least got one. And that looks like all they're going to get. John Jones beats the throw at first.
Yeah, just right there on the grab. It's second for Buckham. Just kind of got stuck in the glove. Managed to get it out before the lead runner reached second, but by the time that all happened, Jones had already reached first.
So the runner at first for Connor Grant, who is 0-for-3 today. Grounded out on a drop third strike. And trying to put down the bunt down the third base side. Beautifully placed. And will just drift foul.
And just a smart play. Let that one roll and roll and roll. If you're not going to throw him out at first, just let it roll and hope it goes foul before it reaches the third base bag or plays dead. So Jones having to walk. I'll walk a little slowly back over to first and we'll do it all again.
All that for strike one. As thrower to first gets by. There goes John Jones racing over to second. He'll take the turn around the bag and slip, trying to get back, and does. As he turned for third and suddenly decided to reverse directions.
Yeah, realized he was never going to make it back to third, so his best chance was to rotate back and dive back for the bag. Just about slipped on the turf and fell down, so kept his grip. And now North Greenville with a runner in scoring position.
Now John Jones advancing up to second, so better opportunity here for Connor Grant. The count's still 0-1. And home run swing misses to put him behind 0-2. That's going to go down as a E1 on the advance. Grant behind 0-2, and lets ball one go by below the knees, 1-2. And ball two. Or no, 3-2 count now. Or no, that should be. Yeah, that's just 2-2. That's a 2-2 count.
Yeah, 2-2 popped up on the board. Just fix that one. Because now it's 3-2.
Yeah, now it's 3-2, so now forget all that. Grant trying to get on base for the first time today as he has a full count. And he'll go down swinging. Strikeout there for Ethan Bailey. I'll move us down to the fifth spot. Previously held down by Andrew Plunkett, who went 3-for-3 today with 2 singles and a double. And in the lineup is number 26, switching to third after coming into pitch run. Cameron Norgren is listed in the 5 spot now. And he will get an at-bat. And missed the first pitch, strike one.
Yeah, golf for that one on the inside. Just Bailey pegged that one down barely above the ankles, but Norgren swinging for the fences.
And ball one, low and away. And a chopper to second. Throw to first. We'll put Norgren down. And that'll retire the side for North Greenville. No runs, no hits, one error, and one left on base. That bottom of the seventh for North Greenville. So the line still holds 4-1 over Emmanuel. And do up for the Lions in the top of the eighth down to their last 6 outs. Balcom leading things off in the top of the 8th, followed by Swindell and Price when we come back here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Sal Lavaggio trying to get North Greenville through the 8th inning after coming in relief for the starter Frankie Fernandez, missing up high, ball one to the second baseman Brock Balcom. And Balcom today has walked, flown out, and singled, all for a grand total of being 1-for-2 as he'll foul this one off to move it to 1-1. Part of the order, you want up for Emmanuel with Balcom having a hit. Swindell has walked to get on base, and Price has walked and tripled today as a short bouncer in the infield will get by Lavaggio, and second hit of the day for Balcom. And now it's going to bring the catcher up, Swindell, with the leadoff man aboard. I'll mention that he has walked. That has been his only time on base today. Other than that, he has gone 0-for with a fly out and a strikeout looking. That will be ruled as a, well, I'm going to double check that. That will be ruled as a hit with Balcom singling back to the pitcher on the bunt. And drop strike is in on Swindell. Sitting at a, yes, that is a 1-1 count. And move it to 1-2. And I do believe I see more activity in the North Greenville bullpen. And, oh boy, it is number 41, Kip Rawlings.
Yeah, got the win yesterday on one pitch, so why not?
Different scenario here.
Yeah, hopefully he won't have to be in line for the win for the North Greenville side.
And swing and a miss. That'll be strike three to put Swindell down away on strikes. Out number one. We'll move us down to the left fielder, Hannon Price, who since grounding out into the double play back in the first inning has gotten on base with a walk and tripled and then scored the, so far, the only run for Emmanuel. He'll take ball one from Lavaggio. And he'll check swing, foul it off for strike one. And swing and no contact on strike two. Lavaggio placing that one downstairs, getting him to chase it.
And you don't normally see a reliever this far into his pitch count do pitching with this much command and a parity between his pitches, just all over the place, hitting 35 right here.
He'll miss that one way up high.
That might have been a waste pitch just to try to catch the runner off of first, but either way, 35 pitches now for Lavaggio and still dealing.
And 16 inning, well, expecting 16 innings tomorrow. As ball three off the artificial turf, runner holds, and it'll be a full count to Price. Well, the good news is Rawlings would still be, I would still consider him fresh after one pitch.
Yeah, don't feel like he used all of his best stuff yesterday. So,
plus, out of the starters for North Greenville this season, we have yet to see Blake Hamilton, who has three starts on the season.
More than likely going to see him tomorrow.
Yeah, now we have seen Burgess, we've seen Garner, and we saw Fernandez today. Now pick off to keep the runner back. Those are the four pitchers that have a start for North Greenville, so
wouldn't be surprised to see Coach Powell start a different guy than his main four.
Yeah, I believe Kanan Cropper, he has starter experience from last year, as this one, high fly ball to right field, Grant drifting back and has it on the run, and that will be the second out. Ooh, danger shot there from Price. Grant hangs on to it, and with two outs, runner still on first, we'll move us down to the DH, Gooden. Gooden is 2-for-3 today with a pair of singles and a strikeout. Strike one into him. And fouled off up high, strike two. So Vaggio jumping ahead 0-2 and one strike away from ending the top of the eighth. Now the 0-2 runner goes outside, throw to second for the out. Beautiful throw, and he
got
is
him.
Out. Ooh, John Jones from behind the plate guns the runner down, and that will retire the side for the Lions.
Just what a throw right there from John Jones, catching over, getting the runner out at second to stop what minor threat the Lions were trying to put together. Now North Greenville with a chance to tack on more runs here in the bottom of the eighth. But as it stands, 4-1 North Greenville after 7.5.
No runs, one hit, no errors, and a runner tagged out at second for the Lions. So leading off the bottom of the eighth for NGU will be, well, should be Chandler, Parsons, and Morris. That is 6, 7, and 8. And might we see Kip Rawlings come out to put it away in the top of the ninth, or with a closer Avery Greer, who picked up a save yesterday in the 4-3 win over Northwood. Well, we'll have to wait and see. So bottom of the eighth first, coming up next here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Jeffrey Chandler leading off the inning for NGU here in the bottom of the eighth, facing off against Ethan Bailey, staying on the mound for the Lions. NGU leading 4-1. Last chance here for North Greenville to tack on whatever they want to in the run department before sending it to the top of the ninth. First pitch swinging, fouled away, strike one to Chandler. It was reached on a fielder's choice, but and then came around to score a run, but since then has not managed to get on base, listed as and he'll hammer this one into right field, and that is foul.
Just so lands right to the outside of the line.
That one was very, very close. It was on the, you know, it was on the line. Must have been just on the wrong side of the line. Chandler listed as 0-3. Behind here, 0-2. And he'll foul this one away off of Bailey. Count still 0-2. And that'll put Chandler down on strikes. One out. We'll move us down to Sponseller listed in the seventh spot as he came in to pitch run a couple of innings ago.
And he's going to get an at bat here.
Sean Parsons did handle the duties in the seventh spot. Walked, grounded out back to the pitcher, and Sponseller hammers this one through the gap into left field.
Sees one pitch, and he's already on base.
That is hit number 9 on the day for North Greenville for Sponseller. Now at first with the one-out single. And Jack Morris, the center fielder, who walked his last time up back in the 6th, listed as 0 for 2 today. And ball 1 way outside. So Morris for the first offering. One oh. I get 2-0. Fouled away. Strike 1 moves it to 2-1. Pickoff no good to keep Sponseller back. And now the runner will go. Low throw on the pitch to second. In and out of the glove of the second baseman. And Sponseller has a stolen base. Ball now, 3 to Morris.
And I was about to say, just add some insult to that. Just the ball was low anyway. So 3-1 count.
Now one down here for North Greenville. Morris setting up here for the 3-1, and we'll take a ball 4 up over the head and a walk down the first. Puts 2 on for North Greenville in the bottom of the 8th with 1 out. And Jared Williams, the second baseman, steps up. All together, reached on a fielder's choice back in the 6th was the 3rd out of that inning. Has grounded out back to the pitcher and doubled all the way back in the 2nd.
Now Evan Mask out to talk with Ethan Bailey. What they're going to do here to try and get past Jared Williams.
And that's a change for Emmanuel. Evan Mask now catching for Ethan Bailey. Everybody else looks to remain, has remained the same. So Swindell looks like he's done as he started at the catching duties. And now here comes the coach. Another pitching change for Emmanuel. Looks like a 36.
And it is.
Zane Corley, a right-handed freshman from Athens, Georgia, will now take to the mound to try and get these next 2 outs for the Lions. And Zane Corley with a 6.75 ERA, no wins, no losses. For Emmanuel, his 3rd appearance here today, through 2 2/3. He's allowed 3 hits, 2 runs, both earned. No walks or strikeouts yet. And 11 batters faced, batting .273 against him. So Corley taking over for Emmanuel.
And Ethan Bailey Ethan Bailey exiting the game, 1 2/3 innings pitch, 1 hit, 2 walks, 2 strikeouts. No extra base hits through 30 pitches, but is responsible for the runners on first and second. So his stat line not closed quite yet.
Third different reliever to the mound for the Lions. And we've been discussing at length today the pitching for North Greenville. Will it wear out? If it does, when will that happen? 2 games tomorrow in a doubleheader, 2 games 2 and 3 of the series overall.
But like you saw the series history after the second inning, North Greenville leading this series quite handily, 19-3 all time. So if Coach Landon Powell is going to have any team come and be the back half of his five games over 4 days, this is the team he wanted to see.
First pitch on the way, got that sidearm motion going, and ball one sent in to Williams. Williams 1 for 3, got his double today. And strike one. Quick step out of the box from Williams, right back in. And missing ball two outside. Ball two outside. Somebody getting vocal from the dugout thought the runner was going. The 2-1. 2-2. Sponsilla, the man on second for North Greenville here with one out. Jared Williams in the box. And jammed up inside, fouled away. No play on the ball from the catcher. Mass chasing after it. Count remains 2-2. Long stare down to the catcher, and strike three is called. Runner goes to third, and he is safe.
And both the runners advancing on that strikeout.
That is out number 2. Sponsiller and Morris with the double steal. Put 2 in scoring position. And another change coming up for Emmanuel. Number 41, Isaac Marshall, a lefty sophomore from Lawrenceville, Georgia. He'll come in.
I don't even have to look up the stat line there for Corley. It's 6 pitches and 1 strikeout for 1/3 of an inning.
And Marshall will have to face the top of the order for NGU, but Ryan Brown has struggled today. Did reach on a fielder's choice last time up, but that was as the inning was ending. And apart from that, has flown out twice and grounded out. Brown with runners at second and third. Can put it out of a save position, which one might think Avery Greer would come in for save number 4. Got one yesterday. That was his third of the season. Kip Rawlings was warming in the bullpen before the last inning for the top of the eighth ended. So Rawlings most likely coming in, and have not seen any action from Greer yet over in left field. It looks like warm-ups are over for Marshall, so Ryan Brown set to come up. And back to action. North Greenville leading 4-1. Two on, two outs. And Brown lets ball one go by.
And that one just real off speed, just sinking low in the zone, missed the bottom of it.
Missing up high, ball two. And missing up high again, ball three. Emmanuel threatened to load him up with two down and put Utah Jones up to the plate.
That's the last thing they want to see.
The last thing they want to see is right after Utah Jones, as there's a strike whistled in. If Brown can reach and then we go through Utah Jones, then we got John Jones. So 3-1 count. And ball four it is.
Now base is loaded. For North Greenville. Utah Jones coming to the plate. One for three with a run, a walk, and a stolen base.
Utah Jones, no home runs on the year. Connor Grant leads the team with four. Altogether, this North Greenville team with 11 home runs through 11 games.
But six of those are right after this spot with two.
Yeah, Jones has one today. Or John Jones
has two on the season, and they're the last 2 days.
Yep.
Then Grant's four.
A delay here, no pitching change for Emmanuel, but the second baseman over to talk with the umpire.
Yeah, that's Brock Bauckham having a word with the infield umpire.
Interesting. Don't normally see a player on umpire conversation.
Yeah, you're normally used to seeing.
Yeah, red-faced coach out there yelling at him.
Yeah, and it looks like that conversation coming not off the hand of Emmanuel doing something, but rather North Greenville, as it looks like they pulled Utah Jones out and pinch hit for him.
Now this game hasn't exactly been smooth today. Coach Powell has been upset with a couple of the calls, and Emmanuel with a couple of plays at first base, and we did have one lengthy discussion earlier today that stopped play for a little bit about runners sliding off the bases.
And this is Eric Gilbert pinch hitting for Utah Jones.
We'll see if I can get a fresh bat in there. Gilbert, let's ball one go by. Gilbert only batting 167 on the year, fourth time he has played today. And he'll foul one away. 1-1. And Gilbert fouls another one away. Strike two. And swung at it in the dirt, dropped by the catcher, can't find it, but all he has to do is tag home, and North Greenville will leave them loaded, and nobody will score.
But that'll end the eighth inning, and North Greenville back defensively, top of the ninth with a three-run lead, looking to close out this game.
No runs on one hit, no errors. North Greenville left them loaded, three on. And so Emmanuel down to their final three outs here in game one. And let's see. Due up for the Lions will be Daniel Good in the DH. Right fielder Jacob Teston and third baseman Jake Nichols we expect to see coming up on the top of the ninth here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Daniel Gooden right back up to the plate, was not able to finish his at bat back in the eighth as Balcom was caught stealing at second. So he will lead things off for Emmanuel. Gooden, Teston, and Nichols do up this inning for Emmanuel. Down three, needing to tie four to take the lead and force it to the bottom of the ninth.
But great, looks like we were wrong. Kip Rawlings got up and was warming up. He thought that Lavaglio might be done after eight, but coming out to trying to use only one reliever to finish out the game.
Well, it's been so far so good for Lavaglio through three that he's done after taking over for Fernandez. And one pitch, one swing, driven foul. I'm not exactly sure where that one landed, but it was...
It's somewhere.
It was high and out there.
It landed on the dirt and not the turf, so that's all we need to know about that.
Ball one low and away. 1-1 count now to Gooden. Also, Eric Gilbert coming in to pitch hit in place of Utah Jones will take his spot at shortstop. As their strike two from Lavaglio, so Gilbert at short, Norgren still at third, and everybody else staying where they have since the first. Ooh, and that one hit him.
That one pegged him. Lavaglio ahead in the count, but got to put a runner on.
Well, North Greenville likes their ninth inning theatrics.
Looks like this is a pinch hitter coming on.
We heard Brandon Taylor coming in for Emmanuel, and he'll foul the first pitch away, strike one. This in place of the right fielder, Teston. Brandon Taylor, number 37. Now, Lavaglio missing. Ball one. Taylor batting 375 in the five games he's been in for Emmanuel. So, roughly half their season. 1-1 count. We'll pop this one up into shallow right. Connor Grant going after it and has it. Ooh, last second adjustment back to his left as... That'll be it for Taylor. One down. And let's see if we see Jake Nichols. It will be Nichols.
0-3 on the day. Against this North Greenville pitching staff.
Flown out, grounded out twice.
And a ground out could possibly end the game with a double play.
Ball one up high to Nichols. Was a double play Nichols grounded out into that ended the sixth. Saulnier is waiting on deck. No call. Ball one. Or ball two. That one looked good from Lavaglio. Well, that one was low and inside. That'll be ball three.
And that's the 50th pitch in relief for Lavaglio. Not a normal stat line, as it looks like Kip Rawlings is back up and throwing in the North Greenville bullpen.
Yeah, he's still out there.
Hasn't been consistently throwing, was sitting down the last half inning or so.
And strike one is called. And sharply hit, foul down the third base side.
Lucky for North Greenville, that one just pinned foul.
That one had double, maybe triple written all over it.
Yeah, left fielder Jeffrey Chandler playing deep to prevent anything getting over their heads. But in the process, that really warrants itself to doubles and triples, extra base hits.
Full count now with one out. And reached out for it. Dribbler to first. Throw back to second. Gets the lead runner. And two down. That was Gooden out. And now we'll come down to the first baseman, Jacob Saulnier, to keep the drive alive for the Lions. Possibly.
Now Lavaglio, the chance for a four-inning save. If he can record this out.
And first pitch swinging, chopper to short. Gilbert has it, flipped to second, and that's the ball game. One pitch, and Lavaglio goes the rest of the way after taking over for Fernandez. And North Greenville will win it for the third straight time here at home at Ray and B. Dillard Field, taking their first conference win of the season over Emmanuel 4-1.
Hey, Gray, the turf's still undefeated.
Yes, I suppose it is. How about that? And North Greenville's going to try and look and keep – keep it undefeated tomorrow with a doubleheader against Emmanuel. Games 2 and 3, first pitch at noon. Game 3 starting after the conclusion of that one, expected around 3 o'clock. And so, no runs, no hits, no errors, one left on base in the top of the ninth for Emmanuel. And let's double check this. Frankie Fernandez should pick up the win today for North Greenville after Kip Rawlings threw one pitch and picked up the win yesterday. And this will be Fernandez's first win of the season, so move Fernandez to 1-0 as he went five innings. And not sure who's going to end up with the loss. Looks like Cornett will end up with the loss as he went 5 1/3.
It should be Cornett after all said and done. Gave up the lead and then never was able to get it back for Emmanuel. So starting pitcher should wind up with the loss after all of that.
And Emmanuel ended up using four relievers after Cornett in that one. And so this is game one in the books. For North Greenville, they win it 4-1. And as always, time to announce your Moses Greer player of the game. And let's see, Utah Jones with a hit. John Jones went 2-for-4. How about Plunkett going 3-for-3 before getting pulled? And Sean Parsons, he went 1-for-2. Sponseller 1-for-1. And Jared Williams 1-for-4. And those look like all the hits for North Greenville. So who gets it?
And right now, you just got to look at that John Jones stat line. Two hits, four, and 2-for-4 from the plate. One RBI, one run, doubled and homered on the day for two of the four North Greenville runs. So, second day in a row, one of the Jones boys.
Yeah, didn't we give John Jones it yesterday?
Well, kind of hard not to when you're putting that kind of performance out there.
Well, fair enough. I'll have to see if somebody can unseat him tomorrow from his current streak of two players of the game awards in a row for John Jones. So games 2 and 3 tomorrow here at Ray and B. Dillard Field. A refreshed look for the home of NGU Crusader baseball. Again, North Greenville wins this one 4-1. If you can't make it out to the ballpark tomorrow, expecting the same beautiful weather we had today as it got almost to 80 degrees. And right now as it stands, some rain in the morning, but that is expected to be out of here by game time. So, doubleheader of baseball tomorrow. Hope you can join us here at the ballpark or right here on the North Greenville Sports Network. So for myself, Gray Sullivan, for Alan Ellis, for Will and Alan Cahaley, and Rondo Thompson, this has been the North Greenville Sports Network.
You almost confused me there.